young St. Lucian author who's a globetrotter, keeping an online journal of her travels around the world. Her journal also documents her life, the good times, the challenges, and a lot of it personal. Hello, I am Natalie Jolifanis, and in focus tonight, our special feature on Lovely Sheridan, the author of A Girl Like Me. Tonight, Lovely talks to Calabash TV about her new book and her personal and professional experiences.
My name is Lovely Sheridan. I am a St. Lucian, born and raised in St. Lucia. As a little girl, I grew up in Marsha. How many of you know Marsha?
It gives me great pleasure this evening to welcome all of you to the University of the West Indies Open Campus, and more so to the much-anticipated launch of A Girl Like Me, written by our own daughter of the soil, Miss Lovely Sheridan.
Being back here, honestly, has just been a wonderful experience. The people have been really supportive, very positive, and at the launch, I felt that reason why I was a bit emotional, because just looking in the audience and seeing the faces of people that have been following me on my journey. I started a blog a few years back, and I was sort of writing about my journey traveling all over the world, and I look around the room and I saw the faces of people who have still stuck with me and have been there and are still supportive. So and being home, I've just been going to different schools, and the students are just really excited. I mean, I speak and I see them sitting and they are listening to my stories and looking at the pictures, and I could see the inspiration and the hope in their eyes, and that truly warms my heart. So I've just been having an amazing time. My grandfather is like my hero, you know. I talk about it in my book. When I was growing up, I wanted to strangle him because he was so strict, and I just felt like he was impossible, pun intended, not impossible. But he would just, you know, but he was very disciplined, and he would always have something important to say. He would always be teaching me a lesson about something or reflecting on something. And then, I mean, obviously I was listening, because as I go through my life and I talk about it in my book, I'm seeing on the journey, you know, how all those valuable lessons that I'm hearing his words in my ears, and it's coming back to me. And he's just having an amazing impact. And I dedicate the book to him because his valuable lessons, I think, truly helped shape me as a young person and guide me along. So he's my personal hero.
I'm especially proud to have my grandfather here. I dedicated the book to him and my son. Okay, I won't talk about that because then I'll get emotional.
You see, my dad took me from my mother. I was 7 months, so I basically grew up with my dad. And my dad really did not have a lot of schooling. But one of the things he did was to tell us, you know, the value of education, tell me. And I was able to pass it down to the children because, I'm going to say, because my dad really worked hard for me to get an education, and I disappointed him because I got pregnant going to high school. So I know Lovely wanted to make him proud. You know, I know he wanted a lot for me, you know, and it didn't happen, you know, and so I'm happy that he's still alive and he could see that, because education for him was key.
I talk about my mom throughout the book. She is just a phenomenal woman. She really defines the term phenomenal woman. She's a single parent of six of us. And, you know, she's always been a strong, hardworking go-getter, you know. And most importantly, she led by example, which I talk about in the book. I think that's one of the things actually that is lacking in not just the world, in our culture especially. A lot of parents are not leading by example. And I was blessed to have a mom that if she said, don't drink, she didn't drink. If she said don't sleep around, she did not sleep around. If she said don't smoke, she don't smoke. Don't curse, she didn't curse. So she was young, but and she was not educated, but she instilled in us the right values. I mean, we went to church, she taught us how to pray, we worshiped as a family. She was just a great and selfless. I mean, she had six kids and she's still taking kids in from the streets and raising kids in our home. So she's a phenomenal woman, and she has a lot to do with the woman that I am, and that's why I reference her a lot in the book. came to Europe and we had a wonderful trip. We went to Italy, Rome, Italy, and Sweden and Denmark, and she loved it. You know, it was an amazing experience for her. I talk a little bit about my father. I didn't go in too deep because, you know, I didn't want to go there just yet. I don't think I'm ready to talk about everything about him as yet, but I love my father. He is a good man, but he wasn't involved in our lives. He was not there. He wasn't a part of my upbringing. I can't say he has a lot to do with the woman that I am, but I do hope to one day have a better relationship with him. It has been a little bit estranged for a little while, and I hope to fix that soon enough.
Let me welcome you once again to the Open Campus. This is Lovely's night, a night that she has worked long and hard to achieve. Let us all celebrate with her and wish her well.
I know how much this night means to her, because this is a homecoming. This is where she was born. This is where she grew up, where she learned the values that shaped her and brought her through the hard times and obstacles and hardships that life brings us from time to time.
I am my own brand. It's unique, beautiful, classy, and created by me. We need to have an identity beyond all branding, because when it's all taken off, we are just naked people in the mirror who are worth a whole lot more than clothes, shoes, and all other colorful accessories. Why not learn to first accessorize our soul before anything else? Lovely Sheridan, from her book, A Girl Like Me.
Standing before you today is a proud mama. And today I'm standing here, not to say much, but as a mother, to give my daughter Lovely the blessing. It's a whole wild world out there. There are a lot to see, and I know you will do well. I wish you well.
Sheridan's story is autobiographical. It's the story of a young woman's journey to fulfill her dreams. For this reason, I'd like to commend Lovely Sheridan for bearing her soul, as it were, for taking us from Monrepo to Miami, Australia to China, to Sweden, Sweden to Japan, etc. I'd like to commend her as well for taking us into her relationships, for sharing her fears, anxieties, as well as her joys. This novel must be a treat for young women and an education for young men.
This is one of the centralized themes in my book, the importance of staying true to your authentic self. Because when we go against ourselves and deny who we are, we can miss out on our true purpose and happiness. The world often tries to make you into the image of everyone else. Don't let them. It is no coincidence that the word unique begins with the letter U. The book, A Girl Like Me, is a reflection of my life while traveling the world. It chronicles my amazing journey of self-discovery through the varied experiences that life had afforded me, both good and bad. One of triumphs, trials, struggles, and failures. I felt a huge responsibility to tell my story because I believed that it could serve as a source of strength and inspiration to many, especially my own people. The theme for today is I Am Possible. I hope that with my story and from reading this book, that when you do hear the word impossible, you can now embrace its new meaning and feel inspired. To any one of you who are pursuing a goal or a dream, I urge you to continue to believe in yourself and don't ever give up. Anything is possible. Look at what God has done for a girl like me. Thank you.
Sometimes, you know, you'd meet kids or grown-ups by that time and say, Miss, you know, I'll never forget what you told me, and Miss, you really had a big influence. But to be to read my name in the book and have certain things said about me, it really makes you, I'll tell you what it does. It lets you know that even though there are days at school where you feel as if you're not reaching anybody, if you can touch a few souls here and there, then it's worth it. It really is worth it.
Lovely is a very, very special girl. And I've known her for a long time. And then the thing is, Lovely, she's a girl, she's been through a lot. And then what has always amazed me, she's always been able to rise above it all. No matter what challenge now she was faced with, she was always able to overcome it. And I always admired that in her. And then also, Lovely and I, we had a very special relationship. And then we would always bond, and then we'd spend countless nights talking and everything like that. And she always made me feel very special, and it was always very easy to talk to her.
Very daring young lady, always knew what she wanted. And I knew one day it would come, I just didn't know when, but I knew it would come.
A Girl Like Me is available at bookstores in St. Lucia, or you can get a copy online. Keep in mind that we can't give away all the details, so get your copy today and support Lovely Sheridan.